Hey guys, welcome back to Kinte's Kitchen. If you are new to this channel, you are very welcome. Today I'm gonna share with you guys a Gambian recipe called plassas. This is my version of plassas. I know this is not the original recipe, but however, I will share the original recipe with you guys soon. This is the ingredients I'm gonna use for the recipe, but as I go, I'm gonna show you guys all the ingredients so you can know what is what. Then I have English spinach. Normally we use sweet potato leaf, but I'm using English spinach. And I have scallion, eggplant, peppers, and seasonings, oil. Yeah, that's all the ingredients I'm gonna use. Salt, seafood, shrimps. Normally we use smoked catfish, but I'm using shrimp and mixed seafood. Now I'm just gonna chop the onions. I'm using one onion, and I'm just gonna chop the scallions and one pepper. One habanero pepper is up to you how you like spice. Then in the pan, I'm just gonna add in the pot oil. I'm using vegetable oil. Then I will add the onion and the scallion and pepper. Then I'm just gonna add the seasoning. I'm gonna use old pepper seasoning. Then I'm just gonna fry it for just the onion get soft. Now I add the old pepper seasoning. I'm just gonna add half of it. Then I will keep it for later. Then I'm gonna add our local seasoning, is dawa dawa. You can find this in African stores. Then I'm just gonna fry it. While it's frying, I'm just gonna go and chop the spinach. I'm just gonna chop the spinach very fine, because you don't need a big chunk of spinach. It's better you chop it very fine. That's how I like it. So I'm just chopping the spinach very fine. Then as you can see, all the spinach is done. Just separate it, put it in the bowl, put it aside. Now in the pan, I'm just gonna check, and the onions are almost soft. Then I will add the spinach. You know, spinach is all, it look a lot, but you will see spinach is almost 85% of water. So then I'm just gonna, now as you can see, the spinach is almost getting soft. As you can see, all spinach is almost 85% of water. Now I add the raw peanut. It's a raw peanut. You just use your blend it, sift it very fine. That's it. Very easy to do. Now I add enough water to cover the soup. Then I will let it come to boil. Before that, I will add the eggplants. They need to cook. If you don't add them at this time, they're not gonna cook. They will be hard. So I add some pepper, habanero pepper, two habanero peppers. And then I will add fish sauce. Fish sauce is very important for this recipe. Normally back home we use dry fish, and I don't have it here. So I'm using, that's why always I use fish sauce for some recipes, like the the dry fish. But sometimes I do have dry fish if I go to the African shop. But as I'm filming this recipe, I am not having dry fish at this moment. That's why I'm using fish sauce. I already add salt, and then let it come to boil. As you can see, after 5 minutes, it's almost coming to boil. But we have to cook this soup for 20 minutes. before we add the seafood. I'm showing you guys how it looks like. It's like a creamy soup because of the raw peanuts. Let it cook for 20 minutes in low heat. Don't put your fire very high, you have to put it very low. After 20 minutes, as you can see, the soup. Now I will add the mixed seafood, the shrimp and fish. This mixed seafood has some fish, so I'm just gonna mix it very well. As you can see, this soup is so creamy, like you can see. Normally back home we use palm oil if we are making this soup, but I'm not adding palm oil to make it healthier. So I add some of the seasoning, all pepper seasoning, and I will add, maybe I will taste, if it's lack of salt, I will add some salt. Then let it cook for another 20 minutes. When it's cooked very well, you will see, because of peanuts, peanuts have some oil, you will see, and we add some oil, you will see oil is coming on. That means that the peanut is cooked very well. If the peanut doesn't cook very well, you will not see any oil come out, because of peanuts have lots of oil. That's it, as you can see, very low heat, you will see your peanut will cook very well. That's it, it's so easy to make this recipe. I hope you guys enjoy this video. If you do, don't forget to subscribe. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, like the video, share with your friends, and I will catch you guys in my next video. And I serve it with white rice, as how we have it back home. That's what I'm doing. Yeah, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, don't forget to give me a big thumbs up, like, share. Yeah, I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye.